Hello and welcome back. We're picking up now in Chapter 6, Developing a Project Plan. Looking at our where we are now map, we've gone through the introduction, strategy, organization, defining the project, estimating, and doing project networks. We will continue along this path and we'll move back to Chapter 10 after we finish 9. Developing a project plan starts with the project network, which is a flowchart that graphically depicts the sequence, interdependencies, and start and finish times of the project job plan of activities that is the critical path through the network. It provides a basis for scheduling labor and equipment, enhances communication, provides an estimate of the project's duration, provides a basis for budgeting cash flow, identifies activities that are critical, and so on. The last point here is that it helps the managers get and stay on plan. This diagram illustrates how the WBS transfers to a network. It shows the lowest element here of the circuit board, and it shows all the different organizational units that are involved in that particular work package. On the next slide, it shows that this is the network diagram of A, B, C through D, F, and K, and it's showing that A is an activity that involves D1 through 2, D1-1, D1-2. It rolls up into the network. The work package just rolls up into the network diagram. So that's what this slide is showing. Important terminology for this chapter are activity, element of the project that requires time. It's shown by a box with a letter on it. The merge activity is an activity that has two or more preceding activities on which it depends. So D would be considered a merge activity because it has predecessor A and B feeding into it. This shows parallel and concurrent activities. It shows that they can occur independently and if desired, not at the same time. And that's because they don't have any dependencies on each other. So in this example, let's see. D and C are not dependent on each other. They have no predecessor relationship. But they are both dependent on activity B. This is just a continuation of that network diagram, showing activity C feeding into D, and it's showing that this is the, these are additional terminology, that path is a sequence of connected and dependent activities. The critical path is the longest path through the activity network that allows for the completion of all project-related activities. So when you look at a network, it's the path of activities that takes the most time, and that's what we'll figure out when we do the backwards and forwards pass through a network diagram in our examples and also in your written assignments. More terminology. An event is a point in time when an activity is started or completed. It does not consume any time. A burst activity, and when we go backwards back to an event, it can also be known as a milestone. Burst activity is an activity that has more than one activity immediately following it. So in this diagram, A has more than one dependency arrow flowing from it. B, C, and D are dependent on A, so A is a burst activity. Two approaches to creating network diagrams are activity on node and activity on arrow. And in this textbook, we're focusing on activity on node. It uses a node to depict an activity versus using an arrow to depict an activity. This slide shows the basic rules to follow when developing project networks. Let's see. So it's showing that networks typically flow from left to right. Activity cannot begin until all of its predecessors, preceding connecting activities, are complete. Arrows indicate precedence and flow and can cross each other. Each activity must have a unique identifying number, that is greater than any of its predecessor activities. Looping is not allowed, conditional statements are not allowed, and use common start and stop notes. This slide shows the fundamentals. A has no predecessors. A precedes B, B precedes C, and C is the end. So A is the start and C is the end. In the second diagram, X is a burst activity that has two nodes, Y and Z, that are depending on it. More fundamental information. It's showing that because J, K, and L have no predecessors and have no relationships among them, they could start at any time in order to work towards completion, and they all precede M. It's also noting that all activities, J, K, and L, must be completed before M can begin. M is also known as a merge activity. This is another diagram showing predecessor and successor relationships. This is a copy of Table 6.1 from your textbook that shows the network information that is used to construct the network diagram. So you have the activities listed, descriptions, and their predecessors, preceding activities on the far right. And this is for the automated warehouse order picking system. It shows just a sample or part of that network diagram that we'll see on the next slide. So this is the complete network. It shows all the activities that were in the information table, define the requirements through integrated systems, and it shows each activity and the preceding activities for it. So, network computation, we complete a forward pass, meaning going from start to finish, to complete the earliest time. ES is the early start, how soon can the activity start? EF is early finish, how soon can the activity finish? And then expected time, ET, is how soon can the project finish. The backwards pass, meaning you start at the project finish and work your way backwards to the left, back to the start. To answer the question and do the computations for how late can the activity start, late start, how late can the activity finish, late finish, which activities represent the critical path, and how long can an activity be delayed, which is the slack or float. This is another view of the automated warehouse picking system and construction of the activity on node diagram shows each node, the duration, the description and also the number, and highlighting what we've already started talking about. This particular activity on node network forward pass starts with 0. And note that there is another way to do this. You could start at 1 instead of 0, but the math is a little bit different, and we'll talk about that in class. But starting from 0, you add the duration to get from the early start to the early finish, and you do that through each one. To the next, each path through the diagram, the forward pass. This is a legend that shows how it's done. Early start, the ID, early finish, slack, late start, the duration, late finish, and description. And so as I was saying, you add the activity times along each path in the network. Early start plus duration is early finish. And you carry it from the early finish to the next activity where it becomes the early start unless the next succeeding activity is a merge activity, meaning there are more than one arrow flowing into it. And in that case, you take the largest early finish of all of the nodes that are going into that particular node. The backwards pass, this is a quick look at that. So it's hiding right now the early start and early finish data. When we got to the end of our project, we had 100 days or 100 units. And so we go backwards and subtract the durations for each until we get back to our early finish of 10. So in this computation slide, subtract activity times along each path in the network. Late finish minus the duration is the late start. You carry the late start to the next activity, going left, where it becomes a late finish of that preceding activity, unless the next succeeding activity is a burst activity, in which case the smallest late finish of all preceding activities is selected. So in this case, going left, you choose the smallest. Determining free slack is the amount of time an activity can be delayed after the start of a longer parallel activity or activities, and it's how long an activity can exceed its early finish date. It's also considered to allow flexibility in scheduling scarce resources. Sensitivity, it's another term. It's a likelihood that the original critical path will change once the project is initiated, and the critical path is a network path that has the least slack in common. So there can be more than one critical path. This is the final view of the warehouse order picking system network diagram with the forward and backwards paths completed. Note that the critical path is marked by the hash lines, and it is the zero slack path. For your team project, you will create a network information list and network diagram that will be the input for your project schedule in Microsoft Project. So we'll do that in the upcoming class. Thank you.